But the day of the Lord, Yahweh Shemyahushai, will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. So it's going to pass away with a great noise. That great noise is thermonuclear destruction, right? This is what it's talking about. The ICBM intercontinental ballistic missile. It says it's going to pass away with a great noise. Okay? And it says the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Going to that word fervent, it goes into passion. The Lord's anger, his passion is going to be in these nukes when they come. Okay? All right? His passion and his anger going to be in them nukes, man. And elements, when you deal with elements, everything that you see is made up of an element. Okay? Break down the molecular structure of all these buildings, the ground, anything, man. Mulch, the bushes, man, the people, the roads, everything goes back to one of those elements on the periodic table. Okay? It's an element. Okay? And the Lord didn't even use all the elements to make everything. People even are made up of hydrogen, two parts hydrogen, one part oxygen, carbon, phosphorus, magnesium, you know. We're made up of those elements too. That's why we have to take minerals, man, in order for your body to stay basically alkaline where you won't get sick. You know, if you put minerals in your body, we're supposed to have 102. If you put minerals in your body, man, then you will not get sick. I was telling the dude that yesterday, man, if your body alkaline, there's no way you're going to get sick. He tried to figure, really? I'm like, yeah, it's because your blood, your alkaline in your blood has went below 7.2. It has went to like 6.9 or 5 or 4. Because you're drinking that acid water. All right, you're not drinking alkaline water, then you eat. You're not eating alkaline foods. You have a lot of people tell you they don't even eat vegetables. They might eat an apple like twice a year. Might eat a banana 4 or 5 times a year. But they eat cheese, chips, potatoes, bread, things that give you diabetes, to bring your alkaline level low, to bring your body in subjection to catch these diseases, which are called diabetes and high blood pressure, man. Okay? You keep your body alkaline, you be straight. And it says, the elements shall be burnt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works therein shall be burnt up. So everything that Esau has created, the Lord is about to burn it down. He told you that in Malachi, the first chapter. Let me get that. He said it right here in Malachi, the first chapter. Malachi 1:1, the burden of the word of Lord Yahweh to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, said the Lord Yahweh, yet he say, wherein has I loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, said the Lord, yet I love Esau, but I love Esau and I hated. I love Jacob and I hated Esau, Salaki, and laid his mountains and his heritage waste from the dragons in the wilderness. Whereas Edom said, we are impoverished, but we will return and build a desolate place. That's what they did during the time of Alexander, right? When the Edomites took over, they started building, and then the Roman Empire, the Edomites ruled, and they came back in the Renaissance period. And that's what you see when they said, we're going to build these desolate places. All these buildings you see in these different cities, man, these skyscrapers, man, they built straight up. These are man-made caves, man, because at the top of it, you got some fucking haughty-ass, arrogant dude at the top of the top of these buildings looking out, looking like he's on top of the world, okay? And it says, we return to build a desolate place, thus said the Lord of hosts, they shall build what I will throw down. So the Lord said, they shall build what I will throw down. He's going to throw it all down with the thermonuclear missiles, right? That's spoken of right there in 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter. It says, and they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom the Lord Yahweh have indignation forever. So these Edomites, the Lord have indignation against them forever. Okay. It says back in 2 Peter 3:11, seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? looking for and hastening to the coming of the day of Yahweh by Hashem Yahushai, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. So that day of the Lord is going to be a day of fire, man. It's going to be a day of anguish. It's going to be a day of gloominess and darkness spoken of in Joel. Okay? It's going to be a day of wrath, man. Spoken of in Isaiah, the 34th chapter. And it says, so knowing that, man, we stay in this, we need, our mind state should be staying in the scriptures, study, being watchful, keeping our watch, Gregorio, being paying attentive, exalting brothers, you know, calling brothers, man, see how brothers are doing. Because, you know, brothers, sometimes their spirit get down, certain things happening. We still in this world. We not going to be spiritually standing up perfect in this world, man. We're going to go through things. So study, you know, call brothers, see how they doing, you know. You know, so it says, verse 13, nevertheless, we according to his promise, look for a new heavens and a new earth wherein righteous dwellers. And he told us about that new heaven in Revelation 21st chapter. I, John, saw the holy city of Jerusalem coming down from heaven, man. Okay, so that new heaven is coming. So this is what we look for. So when we hear these talks of the wars and the rumors of wars, and we see these the viruses that they're putting out there, we know to not panic, and like these people are panicking, because those, they said the end is not yet, you know. We keep our faith until we see, Yahweh Shai on the ship, or until that nuclear destruction, you see that fire coming, you still gotta keep your faith, man, okay? Still got to keep the faith. It says, wherefore, beloved, seeing that ye look for such things, be diligent that ye may be found in him in peace, without spot and without blame. So we got to keep this up, man. You know, because we got brothers that have been in this truth, but basically they come in and then they go right out, right? They don't stay, okay? I'm going to look that word up. Diligent, okay, in that particular scripture. Let's see what we got here.
What's up, man?
What's up, man?
What's up, man? I saw you when I found out I'm from work, but I didn't go there and check my email.
Three, and where were we at? 16 and 17. That word, diligent. Spudazo is to hasten, to exert oneself, to endeavor. So we got to endeavor to stay in this thing, man. All right? Because the Lord is, hey, man, you see it, man. You got all these damn people running crazy right now, man. I'm talking about stores are full with people spending money. They emptying shelves. Like I said before, they ain't making but pennies and nickels at the job, but yet they spending all their money in a damn store because of a virus. Ten more minutes.
I'll be right back. Okay.
Come.
Just got out. We're gonna have the bill.
All right.
All right. We might get.